as well, offline, of course, with the proper attire. We're going to get right into this, though. No explanations here. It is going to be Nito versus Phoenix. Nito, he does main the trio of Shotos, if you will. Basically, the trio of fighting game characters. And that's Kazuya, Terry, and I don't know what skin he's going to pick. He's kind of like shuffling over the skin. Actually, the funny thing is, I actually like all of the skins on Canon. So actually, all the fighting game characters have really good skins.
Oh, yeah, they have really good skins.
So he does have a Terry. He has told me that his Kazuya isn't really up to par yet. It is one of those characters that he only put a little bit of time. So he wants to make sure that if he does play the character, he has had way more practice with the character. Terry is definitely the best character that he has in this set, of course, of characters. But we'll see how it goes. Of course, there's also players like Kless who do really good with Terry. And of course, Phoenix, he was known very well for his Sonic and, of course, Greninja as well.
Yeah, I mean, both very fast characters and also both blue. So, I mean, you can never go wrong with either of them.
They're both blue blurs. They're on the screen for a second and then you get hit by them and then you're like, how did this happen? For Nito, though, he is playing this pretty defensively, as you should. He's kind of well aware of, all right, cool, let's go with Power Wave to force Sonic to interact with me. Right, I kind of want Sonic to stand still. If he goes for an aerial, right, I need to be careful and then get the small combo here.
Yeah, oh, getting hit by that homing attack, though, and getting with the dash attack. Hopefully he gets back. I mean, that was an interesting choice using the Power Wave off stage. That was a risky move using that downer, though.
And I have to commend Phoenix for it, too, because if he did get the spike hitbox, that would have sent Nito all the way back to the ground. And, of course, Sonic could still recover. That did give Nito the chance to come back on the stage, but nonetheless, he's still in the grasp of being hit by Phoenix.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully Phoenix can rack up some damage, like about 50%, just to get him an advantage, because Terry, like all the Shoto characters, can do a lot of damage, especially Terry. The jab-jab power dunk, pretty good combo. Can go up to 30 to 40%. It's insane.
And that's what Phoenix is kind of amounting for here. He really does have to play the hit-and-run strategy. He gets his hits in, he gets out, gets the cross-up cool, look at the reaction, and then he'll go from there. That's your best bet, because the second that you are caught into anything from Terry, any hit, any potential opportunities like that, you could take a lot of damage or lose your stock.
I mean, since this is first game, I'm seeing Phoenix right now just playing a lot of different play styles, like going that run in and go in and run out, but then also go that aggressive and then possibly switch to defensive. Right now, he's just trying to experiment with what Nito struggles with.
Exactly, and that's the best way to do it, is look at your opponent and see how far you can test the waters. What's the deep end and what's not the deep end? For Phoenix here, he knows he's nowhere near the deep end, so he's able to have this big stock right here, 101 to 149. Phoenix remains untouched. There is go activated, so now Phoenix has to kind of respect that to a degree, but he's still got a whole extra stock to play with.
Yeah, and also especially Wolf Buster. I mean, since it's so long, you really have to be careful. Like, maybe that choice of running in, doing damage, and running out, just not trying to commit too much or else Wolf Buster is going to come out and you might get screwed over.
Exactly, and that's still good for Nito to go for it from that angle that you see off the stage, just because that does have an active hitbox on the way down. And if Phoenix tried some sort of edge guard, that would have been something that he would have been hit to his demise. Oh, good there for Phoenix. Honestly, that control to the forward tilt, knowing how well that hitbox sticks out, especially where Nito was in positioning, was really smart.
Yeah.
Safe play.
Yeah, definitely safe. And even if he did miss it, or if Nita air dodge, he could have just shield and try to play it from there.
Yeah.
But it did work out in his favor, and Nito is on his last stock. Good use of the power wave to try to stop Phoenix in his tracks. I mean, since Sonic is so fast, power wave is definitely going to be difficult for Sonic to handle, since Sonic can be hard to control due to his speed.
And that's good for Nito, too, because he's slowly catching up in terms of, all right, I've given Phoenix a lot of breathing room. How am I going to get in? And it is these long-lasting hitboxes that we see out. It is that power wave to force Phoenix. It is that read on that shield. Phoenix was a little bit too close on that one, but he played it right. He knows, all right, cool, let me get in. Let me see if I can get this cross up and see where Nito goes. But now Nito has definitely caught up. Normally, some players would be catching up the next game, but Nito has taken that adaptation to the forefront. And now he's able to do it here.
Nito's actually doing very well. He could actually bring this back. Going for the up air. Ooh, just missing that backward special, but he could. Nice dash attack to reap Phoenix right there.
Yeah, and that's what he's trying to do, is kind of reap Phoenix a little bit more. On Phoenix Enzo, the one thing I like about he's doing is now he has control. He doesn't want to oversell himself here. Like I like that. Hold the shield, get the punish afterward. It's not a big punish, but at this point for Phoenix, he has to take every little hit he can get without going too far and overextending.
Going for the up air and great nair to just add up more damage. Ooh, just missing that dash attack. Wow, that was a great combo there. Bringing him up.
Oh!
Wow.
And I like that forward smash. You know how long that sticks out. You know how it's active. That's the one thing here, but unfortunately, a little bit too close to Nito, and that gave Nito the opportunity to go for that move.
Now that Go is online, it could be an easy Power Geyser Wolf Buster to end the set. I mean, the match.
And that's the thing too I like about Phoenix. He understands that, so you see him kind of use Sonic's movement to get in and out. He's baiting Nito to go for one of those high-value options at this point in the game, that so he can get the punish. That's what Nito wants. He's finally finding his pick here. He takes him all the way out with forward air. That is such an excellent play because he waited for the active frames of Power Dunk to finally end and then get that punish.
Yeah, definitely, because Power Dunk is a very laggy move, number one, so it's very punishable. And that forward air, great knockback, multi-hit move, which racks up more damage equals more knockback.
Yeah, exactly.
Overall, it's just a great move.
I did like how Phoenix played. Like, I do like how Nito was actually able to adapt in that game. But I like how Phoenix saw that adaptation and says, I see the battlefield here, and I know how to read the situation, so let me change things up here and there. That's why we see Phoenix take that game. I think that's what I really always appreciate about Phoenix's gameplay, is he's so understanding of what the battlefield looks like, and he still tries to fight with the tools he has in hand. And that's the beauty of Sonic as a character. You are able to sort of use spin dash, use Sonic's movement, use Sonic's aerials all together to bait out and punish your opponent.
Yeah, and this time we're going Northern King. Very, very interesting choice right now. I mean, it's basically Kalos, but just no walls.
and that's the thing about here. For those of you guys wondering for some lore, Champ is a very huge fan of Final Fantasy VII. So when he found out the stage was legal, he definitely wanted to make the stage as a legal stage here for SoCal.
Yeah, definitely.
Being such a huge fan of Final Fantasy VII. For the stage pick here for Phoenix, look at the space he has to run around from Nito. The platforms on the side offer different edge guarding, but also different landings. So you have to really understand, all right, cool, how am I going to get edge guarded? How am I going to land? Those are the things that Phoenix understands, having all that space to move in, but also retreat too.
Phoenix actually using the top of the platform to his advantage, falling through with the spin jump was a very interesting move. I would see most players trying to jump off of it and possibly go for a dropping aerial.
That's good. I like that.
Yeah, that was a good choice. I mean, definitely because it's like a down tilt and a two frames.
Yeah. Hey, if he goes for a get up, if he goes for a normal get up, even on the shield, it's still a safe poke, so you're able to get that against Phoenix.
Yep.
You'll have to look at the value of what Nito saw in that one, and it definitely paid off. For Phoenix here, he is still honestly cautiously aware of how Nito is. Look at that. Runs back. And he's still able to come back to a round. That's the beauty of the stage choice. And I really like how Phoenix is able to use that.
Since all the space is so useful, Nito's probably going to commit to something. And since Sonic is so fast, it's an easy run back and possibly just go back to him, grab him, dash attack, pretty much anything.
Yeah, I did like that up smash from Phoenix just to see if Nito was going to go for a full hop aerial of some sort. And up smash would have punished that, but unfortunately he just missed it. And that's the thing about Phoenix also understanding the landing from Terry. Terry, landing options.
Oh, that was a nice spike.
That is an excellent spike, and that's all from one hit. But that's why we saw Phoenix play as safe as he is, and he's able to take that hit and bring it back.
Oh, he canceled out the spin dash. That was an interesting choice. Probably just to fake out Nito to see, like, oh, he's probably going to go for this, but then switches it up last second. Oh, wow. These spin dash to homing attack is racking up the damage so much.
Yeah, and you can see that from Phoenix all the way, too. He understood, like, all right, cool, another power dunk here. This is my opportunity. And I'm even behind Nito at the same time. Why not go for it?
What I'm seeing from Phoenix a lot is a lot of spin dashes. Great combo starter, as we're seeing, to forward air, up air, neutral air, to a lot, and homing attack. Hopefully he's able to make it back. Okay. Oh,
yeah, that's it.
Wow.
That's it. The thing about Rising Tackle specifically is your hurtbox is still out there at the ledge, and that's coincidentally his feet.
Yeah.
And for Sonic to just go for the angle.